What's going on, YouTube? This is Dark Light Dreamer coming at you with another Q&A video, and man, it's kind of been an uneventful week. I haven't really had a lot of things going on this week except, you know, work and working on videos for you guys. And speaking of videos, if you guys have not seen my collaboration video with Sabijin Games, that went pretty freaking well. Please go check it out. I think you guys will really enjoy it, and I really hope you do enjoy it because it took me about 4 different full recordings to get that right, because the first 3 times I had technical issues with the video after I already recorded the whole run. So in 1 day I recorded the same episode 3 times, and a few days later I finally managed to re-record it, and it finally took this time, you know, between running out of space and the sound balance not being right. So I had a lot of issues trying to get that episode out, so I had to work really hard to get that episode out, so yeah, I hope you guys enjoy that. It was definitely a lot of fun because I was not expecting to enjoy The Binding of Isaac as much as I actually do, but now I really, really love it, so I really want to find time to play it every so often. I really didn't think I would like that game as much as I actually do. It really, really surprised me. So there's a couple of channels that I wanted to bring up that I didn't bring up in my last couple of episodes, but I've been following them pretty religiously, and I think you guys might enjoy them as well. One of which is Langsta, who's been up ever since the release of Final Fantasy XV, and what his channel does is he recreates the foods from Final Fantasy XV. If you guys have seen anything about the game, you know there's all kinds of delicious-looking food in that game, and they give your party different stats whenever you make them in camp if you have the ingredients, and you can find these different foods at inns and stuff like that. But all the food in Final Fantasy XV looks fantastic, and it's very realistic food, food that you would see in our world. There's a lot of equivalent ingredients in that fantasy world to our real world. So Langsta strives to recreate these dishes from everything he sees and all the information he can gather from the game and make a real-life version of it. And it's really, really interesting. I love seeing his recipes and seeing them come together. He's done a handful of them so far, but he strives to make every single recipe that's feasible in the game, which is going to be hundreds. So I'm going to leave a link down in the description below. Check him out. The next episode he plans on doing is King Stew, which was requested by yours truly. So I'm really looking forward to the release of that episode coming out in probably a couple of days. So yeah, check him out. Another small YouTuber that I just came across recently, some of you already know, her name is EFG. Right now she is very, very small time. She has very, very few subscribers and videos up as of yet, but the few videos she does have up are really, really good. She has a very, very good camera presence and a voice for YouTube. So I really think that she deserves a lot of support. She is really good at what she does, and also, you know, she has a very pretty face that doesn't hurt. But she does makeup tutorials, cosplay, special effects, and she plans on doing some DIYs in the future. I'm really looking forward to seeing what she has in store for the future. Another small channel that I've given a lot of attention to lately is Funky Hurdles, or Hurdles, and he does a lot of video game music remixes. So he's really, really good at what he does, but he doesn't have a lot of content out right now, so I'm looking forward to seeing him pop up more. Also, if you guys have not checked out Kalamaru Krishnanada yet, I know I've linked a few of his videos in my Q&A videos before. He usually does Rocket League content in his YouTube videos, but lately he's been doing a lot of Twitch, a lot of live streaming, so if you guys find the time to check him out, I'm going to leave a link to his Twitch channel down below and his Twitter account, so check him out. He's really good at what he does, and he's just getting better and better all the time. He's playing all kinds of different games on Twitch, not just Rocket League, and some of which I'm really interested in seeing more about, so do me a favor and check out his Twitch whenever he has a live stream available. I know he plans on doing some more YouTube videos in the future. Other than that, what's been going on in my life? My diet is going quite well. I'm down to 230 pounds. So I'm almost down in the 320s, which is a big jump from the 246 that I started off at, or 246.6 actually. So I've lost almost 17 pounds total. So I'm really, really proud of that. My goal is to go down to 220 before my birthday, March 22nd. So I think that's a very attainable goal. I think that I can definitely do it, so I'm going to need y'all's continued support in helping me continue to stay on track on that diet so I don't, you know, just completely fall off the wagon, because I really, really miss a lot of the food that I can't eat right now. But, you know, I'll have my cheat days here and there, and it'll be all good. I think that I'll definitely reach 220 by my birthday, and maybe hopefully eventually I'll hit 200 pounds or maybe less. So I just want to continue on this trend and keep on fighting, keep on being productive throughout my whole year. My Thai lessons kind of teetered off in the past week because I was just so busy and I didn't have time to do it. But the last couple days I've been on track, continuing on. I'll show you guys a little bit of my previous lesson because it was difficult. I'm on the 19th lesson out of 25 for the alphabet. So as you can see, it was quite difficult. It was not an easy lesson to go through, but after I've learned the last chunk of that, before I move on to learning conversational things and sentence structure and stuff like that, I'm going to make sure I have all this down. I'm going to put this all on flashcards and go through it until it's second nature. And then once that's second nature, I'm going to go on to trying to form sentences and everything like that, and being able to sight read, things like that. So That's going pretty well. I'm back on the wagon with that. Oh, another really important thing I almost forgot to mention. So tomorrow, I'm posting up another episode of Outlast. It will be episode 3. Really looking forward to playing that because I'm really enjoying the game so far. It's creepy, and it scares me quite a bit. You guys see me panic a lot in the last two episodes that I posted up. But next week, Monday, Wednesday, or Saturday, I will not be posting any Outlast episodes because I have some special things planned for Valentine's week. And it's going to be funny and hilarious, and I hope you guys enjoy that, even though it's not me, you know, screaming my pants off, getting scared. So I wanted to bring up a couple of people in this episode that I've already mentioned a couple of times in my last couple of videos, but I wanted to give a big thank you to Oversoul Gaming, who's been really continuing to support this channel on practically a daily basis, both on this channel and outside of this channel. And thanks to his efforts, I've gotten a pretty big surge of subscribers in the last week. I've gotten about 6 or 7 brand new faces on YouTube that all came from his channel. So thank you very much for those efforts. And for those of you that came from his channel, I want to give you a big welcome to the channel. And I really hope that you're enjoying the content that you've seen so far. Also, Alonzo the Gamer / Alonzo the Rebel is going to be dropping a new song in the near future. He dropped a snippet of it recently. He produces music alongside of also doing his skits and his Let's Plays for video games and stuff like that. So he does all kinds of different things. He is extremely talented, and I'm really loving the clip that he dropped recently. I'm going to leave a link to that music clip down below. Check it out for yourself, and keep an eye out on his channel, Alonzo the Rebel, for that supposed music video in the near future. I'm really, really looking forward to that. Other than that, I don't think I have a lot else going on in my life, so I know you guys aren't here for that. What you guys are here for is to hear some of the answers that you had to some of the questions that you guys asked me in the Q&A video that I posted up last Q&A Friday, so let's get right into it. Kujahira says, "Dude, you're awesome. Good luck in college, and dreams are always achievable with work, so it will happen. And with YouTube, I understand about wanting to be bigger. I'm working towards the same, wanting to be able to post helpful content for wargamers, etc. Thank you very, very much for all the support you've given me lately, Kuja. You have just been awesome in the last couple of weeks in supporting this channel." If you guys do not know Kujahira already, go check out his channel. He does mostly wargaming content, I think Monday through Friday. He also does some Let's Plays. He hasn't posted up any recently, but I know he said in his most recent vlog-type video that he is planning on doing more Let's Play content in the near future. And he also does he just started a Sunday kind of vlog Q&A type video series. So do me a favor and go check him out. He has just been awesome in supporting this channel recently. His question for the week is, what do you think about the 40K universe and game? I really, really enjoy it. I really like how well thought out and complex the lore is in the Warhammer 40K universe. I love all the different factions and everything like that. They all have a lot of fluff. There's just a lot to it. It's more, a lot more than just a, you know, models fighting each other with stats. It has a lot of storyline to it, and, you know, I'm all about a really good story. And so far, everything I've heard about the Warhammer 40K universe is really, really cool. So I really, really like it. I like the game a lot. I wish I had more time to invest in the hobby, but unfortunately, the Warhammer 40K hobby takes a lot of time and effort that I just do not have the time to invest into it. Between my YouTube channel for gaming, between trying to learn Thai, and keeping up with YouTube in general, I have no time between that and work, really. I barely have time to make for friends and things like that. So I just don't have time lately to play Warhammer 40K, but I really, really do enjoy playing it. I really would love to grow my army more in the future. He also says, I will be available when I can to do a collab play with games on Steam and Xbox One if you want to. Stay awesome. I'm totally always open to doing that kind of thing. I know that I've mentioned wanting to do Ruby Grimmy Clips with some people in the future, and as well as any other games that you can think of collabing with. I know that you play Borderlands. I have Borderlands and Borderlands 2 on Steam, as well as a slew of other games. So just let me know what you want to do, when you want to do it. I'm kind of a difficult person to line up schedules with, unfortunately, because of the way that my life is laid out. It's hard for me to be able to do a direct collab with people, but if you can sync up with my schedule, man, I'd be more than happy to. Tattoo for you, Richard says, my brother, you are the bomb, my friend. Thank you very much. Love your goals. You can rock this like no other. I really, really appreciate all the support, Richard. You are a daily inspiration. As a matter of fact, your daily videos on Facebook keep me going every day, reminding me that I can do so much more with my life. So thank you very much for everything that you do. He says, where did you get your intro? I'm assuming you mean specifically for this Q&A series. And that intro is from an anime called Clannad. It's an anime series that I really, really love. It's a drama, it's an emotional roller coaster that's up and down and up and down. It really pulls at the heartstrings. It's got a lot of romance in it. It's got sad parts and funny parts and aw parts. I really, really enjoy it. But the reason I use that ending for the intro of this, just a clip of that, is because it's a big theme in Clannad is these dongo. A character in the series really, really loves dongo, which if you don't know is a Japanese snack made with rice flour and all that is a sweet treat, and there's a show apparently that they always refer to in this this anime as the Big Dongo Family. It's apparently a big show, as a show that's really popular amongst kids. And what it's about is like all these like living dongo with eyes and everything that all different, and there's millions of them, the Big Dongo Family. And even though they're all different and don't always get along, they're just one big family, and you know, they'll stick with each other no matter what. So the reason I use that for the intro of Q&A Friday is it's kind of that sense of community that I think that, you know, the series is all about, that my channel is all about. I want us to all feel like one big happy family here on my channel. So that is why I use the Big Dongo Family opening or endings theme of Clannad as the opening of this Q&A series. Also, on top of that, he says, cosplay, think epic, what or who would you dress up as? That is a difficult question, because there's a lot of cosplays that I would absolutely love to do. There are definitely original characters that I would really, really love to cosplay, characters that we've come up with for our stories. I really love to cosplay as my Ruby character at some point. I would really love to do a Ruby cosplay in general, because I just really absolutely love the series. If you guys have not seen Ruby, please check it out. I think you guys will really like it. I also would love to do some Fate Stay Night characters, namely Assassin from Fate Stay Night. I've talked about wanting to do that. I really love the Fate series in general. It's my favorite anime series of all time. If you guys have not seen Fate Stay Night, check it out. It's my favorite. Absolutely love it. I would definitely love to do Makenshi at one point from Final Fantasy Unlimited. He's one of my favorite characters of all time. Oh, another one that I've really, really wanted to do for quite some time is Brandon Heat from Gungrave. I think me and Mythos talked about doing a dual cosplay of him as Harry McDowell and I as Brandon Heat. I really, really would like to do that at one point. But yeah, I think those are the main ones that I can think of. I can't think of any other ones. I mean, I would love to do Gaul from Generator Gaul in his big armored form, but I don't know how easy that would be. That would be really, really difficult. And I don't want to do any ones that are really, really overdone, like Sephiroth from Final Fantasy VII would be cool, but everyone's done it a million times and everyone's seen it a million times. Noctis from Final Fantasy XV would be pretty awesome, but if I can think of any other ones I would like to cosplay as, I will totally let you know if I think of any. So thank you very, very much for your questions this week. Sabijan over at Sabijan Games says, really appreciate the shoutouts, man. You're very, very welcome. It really does mean a lot. I'm super excited to upload Home Sweet Home and more excited to see you play Isaac. I am super looking forward to seeing your reactions to playing Home Sweet Home. I think he said he's going to have that up today, so by the time this video comes up, it's probably over on his channel already. So please do me a favor and check that out. I look forward to seeing your Let's Play of Outlast 2. Also, great choice of music. Is it from Chrono Cross? It sounds Chrono Trigger-y. It is from Chrono Cross from last week, Laura Last Q&A Friday. That was a Dreams from Another Shore on the Chrono Cross album. It was the world map theme from whenever you go to the other world. So really, really, really love the Chrono Trigger and Chrono Cross series. He says, my question for the week, what does success on YouTube look like to you? I think they're definitely different kinds of success on YouTube. There is the success in that you have people that watch your videos and interact with you and everything. And I think that that's plenty of success for me. There's obviously the success where you make tons of money on YouTube and can make it your career. I mean, even I would even consider success on YouTube to be not make a ton of money. If I could make enough money to live off of YouTube, even if I had to scrape by, that would be plenty for me. I would feel very, very successful in doing just that for YouTube. But I feel like I'm successful in a way on YouTube already because I have people that like to watch my content, that interact with me on a regular basis. That's more than what a lot of people have, I think. A lot of people struggle just to get to the point where they have interaction on their channel. And definitely love the fact that I don't feel like I have to be on this journey alone. And in that, I feel like I'm successful to a degree already. Not as successful as I would love to be. I would love to be in the position where I'm making enough money on YouTube to live. But I definitely feel successful in that. Really, I feel like I've succeeded even if one person tells me that they really enjoyed my video. That I feel like I've definitely succeeded in a large degree just in that. So. Anyway, that's what success on YouTube, I think, is to me. So, thank you for your question, Sabijan. Wolf Brother Mythos over the channel Frost and Fist says, "Great video, my brother. I love that you used the Chrono Cross theme. I really, really love that entire soundtrack on that game. Great answer on networking, too. On my questions, it's a shame that you don't have hobby time anymore. I truly believe that you would be amazing with a little practice. I'm glad one of us has confidence in that." Also, you really brought back some memories. I remember the days of Final Fantasy spamming. Level 99 on Mandalia Plains and level 35 with the spell Beta in Chapter 1 of Final Fantasy VII. Much love, bro. Thank you very, very much. And your question for the week was, what character in any shape or form would I want to see made into a Warhammer 40k model? And my answer is a little bit different. It's not quite a character per se, but I'd really love to see the Jehuti and the Anubis from Zone of the Enders made into vehicles in the Warhammer 40k universe. Like mechs, kind of like my Wraithguard and stuff like that. I think that they would be really, really badass, and I think that would be really cool alongside of the other Warhammer 40k models. I really, really love the streamlined design of those particular mechs, and I think they could really fit in really well with some of their weapons and special rules. So yeah, I think that's going to be my answer to that question. So thank you very much for your question. Wargamer Sean says, "Awesome Q&A, man. Good luck with college and your dreams. Never let anyone tell you that you can't do it." Thank you very, very much for all the support, Wargamer Sean. I really, really appreciate it. Keep pushing. What are your plans, if any, for the Eldar? Eventually, like I said, I don't have much time for hobbying lately, but eventually I would really, really love to finish my regular Eldar army. I want to get two... Wraith Knights. I don't know why I couldn't think of that for the moment. I want to get two more Wraith Knights eventually, and more bikes, and I want to get more Warp Spiders, and more vehicles. I want to go into some of the Forge World stuff and improve my Eldar army. I want to eventually build a Corsair side army, so that way they can ally with each other. I have a lot of things I would love to do with the Eldar, but I just don't have the current funds, which are currently being directed towards the channel and stuff for gaming and stuff like that. And I don't have the time. I really wish I wish I did, because I really, really enjoy Warhammer 40k. It's just a less of a priority than my channel. Oversoul at Oversoul Gaming says, "I love that you seem to almost always use music from JRPGs. JRPGs are my favorite genre. I've been playing JRPGs since I was little. Actually, my first RPG that I ever played was Chrono Trigger, and then shortly after Final Fantasy IV and Final Fantasy VI, or Final Fantasy II and III, as they were on the Super Nintendo back then. So I really have a love for JRPGs and the music in JRPGs, so I use JRPG music for this, and they seem perfect, a lot of the songs for these Q&A videos, so that's why I use them. He also says, "Oh, okay, I thought of a question. Do you think if you didn't have a job besides YouTube, as in if this was the only thing you were doing, do you think you would upload videos more frequently?" I definitely, definitely think that if I didn't have a regular 10 p.m. to 7 a.m. job, if I didn't have to worry about working 40 hours a week, I would definitely have more content on my channel. I would love to be able to have daily content on my channel, one video a day at least. My schedule doesn't allow for it. I'm stretching myself far enough as it is at the moment, doing four videos a week. So if I didn't have to worry about any of that, definitely. After I pursued college, because I think that that while I was doing college, I would still want to stay limited to three or four videos a week. But if YouTube was the only thing I had to worry about, I would definitely do a video a day, especially if that was my means of income. You know, more videos equals more income. So. I just love doing YouTube, and if I didn't have to worry about anything else, doing what I love every day, I mean, that's a no-brainer. And I said, would it be something like my schedule or more frequent, but not that frequent? Also, would you upload more than one video in a day? I think at first, maybe I wouldn't upload more than one video in a day. I know for smaller YouTubers, some people think it's a little bit of a turnoff to have a crap ton of content, and some people don't want to follow smaller YouTubers that post up too much content just because they don't want to keep up with it. I think if I ever reached a level that I was like really, really popular, like Markiplier and stuff like that, and they wanted to see just more of my content, then yeah. If it was something that the community wanted to see, short answer, yes. If I didn't have to worry about anything else other than YouTube, and they wanted to see more than one video a day, I would definitely do more than one video a day. That just would just be up to the community. So thank you very much for your question, Oversoul. James says, hey again, it's been a really busy few weeks with family coming over, but things have been really positive. I'm really, really glad things have been positive for you. I can't wait to see you play Outlast, and your answer was really helpful. Can I just say that when I get my channel up and running, I'd love to do a wee collab, if you don't mind, a Northern Irish band on your channel. Of course, I would not mind at all. I would love to do a collab with you if we can sync up our schedules. And I'm really, really glad that my answer to your question helped you out. And I cannot wait for your channel to pop up, man. I'm really looking forward to seeing some content pop up. He says, you know, hearing you talk the way you do in this video has really made me more wanting to pursue my dream to be a Let's Player. I am really, really glad that my channel can help you out that much, man. It really means a lot to me that you took that much inspiration from it. I cannot wait to see what comes of it. I'm really, really excited for you. So my question for this week, is there a gaming challenge you really want to try? Short answer, I don't really know of a lot of gaming challenges, other than just, you know, beating really, really difficult games and stuff like that. I can't think of any particular ones that I would want to try. I thought about doing a Let's Rage series or a Let's Die series, where I play something really, really difficult and legit try to beat it, but, you know, end up dying multiple times and just getting more and more angry at the series, like a Toho game or something like that. But I don't have a particular challenge that I would want to do. I'm not a very competitive person. I'm not one to go after challenges just doing challenges, but if it's something that the audience wants to see, then I'm very, very open to doing it. I'm thinking about doing some real-life challenges rather than gaming challenges for this channel, just because I think that'd be, you know, really funny and entertaining for you guys. But if there are challenges that you guys want to see me try to do, then by all means, let me know, and I'm totally open to doing them and raging and trying to get that. But I'm not a great gamer, so I'm probably going to fail it, just as a forewarning. I think I have one more question, and that is not actually posted up on here. It's another one by Kujahira from his channel, and he wants to know what my favorite vehicle in my faction in my Warhammer 40K army is. So, short answer, my favorite vehicle in my army is definitely my Wave Serpent. I like the look of my my Hemlock Wraith Fighter a lot, slash my, I can't even think of what it's called right now. The other Eldar Jet, which names escapes me right this second. But I love the way that looks. They're very streamlined. I love the look of it. But my favorite vehicle by far is the Wave Serpent, because they deliver my my Wraith Guard over to the enemy and with their D size, and that's just been invaluable in a lot of games that I've played, just delivering death to my enemies. So Wave Serpent is quite tanky and quite survivable, and gets over a lot of the field really, really quickly, and the next turn I can dump my Wraith Guard down with their D size. I really, really enjoy that. Even if not for the Wraith Guard, it just makes for a great transport for anything I want to deliver across the battlefield. So that's my favorite vehicle in my army so far. Right now I don't have a lot of vehicles. I have my Jet, my Wave Serpent, and I think another tank that I can use as a Wave Serpent, but I don't have a lot of vehicles right now. I want to get more vehicles in the future. I love painting and building vehicles. I love building big models. They're just fun to put together and fun to paint. I don't know why. I'm get more frustrated when I try to put together little bitty models. And they're little bitty parts, and I just have big clumsy ass fingers. So, I like building big things. So, anyway, thank you for your question. And I think that's all the questions that you guys had for me this week. If you guys have any more questions, please, please do not hesitate to drop those questions down in the comment section below, and I'll get to answering those questions in the Q&A Friday video next week. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please do me a huge favor, hit that thumbs up button down below. It really and truly means a lot more to me than you guys know. Do me a favor, drop some comments too, even if they're not questions. I just love chatting with you guys. I love hearing from you guys. It just really and truly makes my day. And if you haven't hit the subscribe button yet, you guys know that I would love to have you guys as a member of the Darklight family, and hope that we'll continue this YouTube journey together again very, very soon. And until then, may your dreams light your darkest hour, and I'll see you next time.